ಗಣೇಶಾಯ ನಮಃ ಓಂ ಶ್ರೀ ಸರಸ್ವತ್ಯೈ ನಮಃ ಓಂ ಶ್ರೀ ಗುರುಭ್ಯೋ ನಮಃ ಓಂ ಸಮಸ್ತ ಜನ ಕಲ್ಯಾಣೇ ನಿರತಂ ಕರುಣಾಮಯಂ ನಮಾಮಿ ಚಿನ್ಮಯಂ ದೇವಂ ಸದ್ಗುರುಂ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮವಿದ್ವರಂ ಸದ್ಗುರುಂ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮವಿದ್ವರಂ ಶುಕ್ಲಾಂಬರಧರಂ ವಿಷ್ಣು ಶಶಿವರ್ಣಂ ಚತುರ್ಭುಜಂ ಪ್ರಸನ್ನವದನಂ ಧ್ಯಾಯೇತ್ ಸರ್ವವಿಘ್ನೋಪಶಾಂತಯೇ ವ್ಯಾಸಂ ವಸಿಷ್ಠನಪ್ತಾರಂ ಶಕ್ತೇಃ ಪೌತ್ರಮಕಲ್ಮಷಂ ಪರಾಶರಾತ್ಮಜಂ ವಂದೇ ಶುಕತಾತಂ ತಪೋನಿಧಿಂ ವ್ಯಾಸಾಯ ವಿಷ್ಣುರೂಪಾಯ ವ್ಯಾಸರೂಪಾಯ ವಿಷ್ಣವೇ ನಮೋ ವೈ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮನಿಧಯೇ ವಾಸಿಷ್ಠಾಯ ನಮೋ ನಮಃ ವಸುದೇವಸುತಂ ದೇವಂ ಕಂಸಚಾಣೂರಮರ್ದನಂ ದೇವಕೀ ಪರಮಾನಂದಂ ಕೃಷ್ಣಂ ವಂದೇ ಜಗದ್ಗುರುಂ ಕೃಷ್ಣಂ ವಂದೇ ಜಗದ್ಗುರುಂ ನಾರಾಯಣಂ ನಮಸ್ಕೃತ್ಯ ನರಂ ಚೈವ ನರೋತ್ತಮಂ ದೇವೀಂ ಸರಸ್ವತೀಂ ವ್ಯಾಸಂ ತತೋ ಜಯಮುದೀರಯೇತ್ ಓಂ ನಮೋ ವಸಿಷ್ಠಾಯ ಮಹಾವ್ರತಾಯ ಪರಾಶರಂ ವೇದನಿಧಿಂ ನಮಸ್ಯೇ ನಮೋಸ್ತ್ವನಂತಾಯ ಮಹೋರಗಾಯ ನಮೋಸ್ತು ಸಿದ್ಧೇಭ್ಯ ಇಹಾಕ್ಷಯೇಭ್ಯಃ ನಮೋಸ್ತು ಋಷಿಭ್ಯಃ ಪರಮಂ ಪರೇಷಾಂ ದೇವೇಷು ದೇವಂ ವರದಂ ವರಾಣಾಂ ಸಹಸ್ರಶೀರ್ಷಾಯ ನಮಃ ಶಿವಾಯ ಸಹಸ್ರನಾಮಾಯ ಜನಾರ್ದನಾಯ ಸೋಕಃ ಯಕ್ಷ ಉವಾಚ ಕಃ ಪಂಡಿತಃ ಪುಮಾನ್ ಜ್ಞೇಯಃ ನಾಸ್ತಿಕಃ ಕಶ್ಚ ಉಚ್ಯತೆ ಕೋ ಮೂರ್ಖಃ ಕಶ್ಚ ಕಾಮ ಸ್ಯಾತ್ ಕೋ ಮತ್ಸರಃ ಇತಿ ಸ್ಮೃತಃ ಫೈವ್ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ಸ್ ಆಸ್ಕ್ಡ್ ಓಕೆ ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ಪಂಡಿತ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹೂ ಈಸ್ ಎನ್ ಎಥಿಯಿಸ್ಟ್ ಹೂ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಫೂಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಸೈರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮತ್ಸರಃ ಆರ್ ಎನ್ವಿ ಯುಧಿಷ್ಠಿರ ಉವಾಚ ಧರ್ಮಜ್ಞಃ ಪಂಡಿತೋ ಜ್ಞೇಯೋ ನಾಸ್ತಿಕೋ ಮೂರ್ಖ ಉಚ್ಯತೆ ಕಾಮಃ ಸಂಸಾರ ಹೇತುಶ್ಚ ವೃತ್ತಾಪೋ ಮತ್ಸರ ಸ್ಮೃತಃ ನೌ ಯುಧಿಷ್ಠಿರ ಸೆಡ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಸಿ ನೌ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಕಃ ಪಂಡಿತಃ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ವಿ ಶಲ್ ಸಿ ದಿಸ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಸೊ ಯುಧಿಷ್ಠಿರ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಧರ್ಮಜ್ಞಃ ಪಂಡಿತಃ ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಪಂಡಿತ್ ದ ನೋಯರ್ ಆಫ್ ಧರ್ಮ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಪಂಡಿತ್ ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ One who knows dharma means what? The one who knows dharma alone is to be considered as a learned man. Otherwise he or she cannot be a pandit, a person. Number one. Now here, dharma here used, you know, is the sense of practicality. Practicality means what? In the sense of performing our duties, doing our duties, responsibilities, etc. Something what we are supposed to do. In that sense, dharma is used here. Now, who knows what is to be done? A learned man only knows. In life, between birth and death, every moment, this question does arise in our minds that what to do, how to do, where to do. If suppose somebody says, don't do that, then why should not I do? And you tell me, can we lead our life without entertaining these questions? It's not possible to live. I want to cook food. How to cook? I want to go there. How to go? I want to do that. How to do? I want to sing. How to sing? I want to practice. How to practice? So wherever this dharma, in the sense of doing or performing our duties, so the knowledge is essential. So the learned man, ka panditaha, dharmajnaha, the knower of dharma alone is a pandit here. What time has to be done, where to do, how long to do. Minus these questions, we would not be in a position to live our life. It's even not possible to live. Think. So, a mere learned person, a merely learned person, who, dharma is a word used now in the sense of practicing it, implementing. So, a merely learned person who doesn't know how to translate his knowledge into action, जो क्रियात्मक नहीं है अपने जीवन में, क्रियाशील नहीं होता है. नॉलेज इज देयर बट आई डोंट नो. लाइक फॉर एग्जांपल वी से व्हाट इज द साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी. साइंस इज नोन टू अस बट टेक्नोलॉजी हैज टू बी डेवलप्ड इन मोस्ट ऑफ द एरियाज. सो सिमिलरली व्हेन वी डोंट नो हाउ टू ट्रांसलेट व्हाट वी अंडरस्टैंड दैट नॉलेज इज एक्चुअली प्रैक्टिकली ऑफ नो यूज. Then, you know, but knowing is not a pandit here. According to Yudhishthira, dharma jnaha, simple knower. Dharma in the word, with which word is used now, dharma has a lot of meanings. Here, which word? Simply knowing is not considered as a pandit. One who is translating his knowledge or wisdom into action, one who is living what he has learned, he alone is considered as a... So otherwise, you know, because learning is useful only when it is practiced, implemented, translated into action. Otherwise, what is the use of mere learning? So, here, jnana is simple, the knower, knower of dharma is a pandit, no doubt about it. Actually, who is a pandit then? A knower, really if we are knower of something, that knowledge would thrust us to perform. What is that knowledge which thrusts us to perform? I am not talking of the Ajñātmika Jñānam, where there is no, only Jñānam is required and no karma is required afterwards. Mere knowing is enough. I am not talking of absolute truth. There in absolute truth only, mere knowing is for not followed by any action takes place. Know it, full stop. Paramātma ko jānne ke baad kya karna hai? This is a redundant, stupid question. Once I know him, that's the end matter. Here dharma is living, the practicality. So who is a pandit? He is a pandit who has understood, who knows what dharma. That means a real dharma, knowledge of dharma would thrust us to perform. So a learned man means what? One who is practically implementing what he has learned. And dharma is word is used in sense of duty. Duty means not knowing duties. Duty means always, within brackets, action is understood there. When we say know your duties, within brackets, follow, perform. That is the meaning. Don't you know your duty? Meaning what? Don't you know what is to be done by you? That is the meaning. That is understood. So here, for dharma, ko panditaha, ka panditaha, dharmajnyo, dharmajnaha, panditaha. That is the word answered. He alone is called a pandit. Okay, now here we saw, what was the second question? Ka panditah puman jnyeyaha, okay. Nastikaha kascha uchyate. Who is a nastika? And third question is ko murkaha. Now, Yudhishthira, when who is a nastika and who is a murkha, these two questions are asked. He gave only one answer for these two. Why? Nastika is a murkha and murkha is a nastika. He integrated it. Who is a fool? Murkha. A nastika is a murkha. Who is a nastika? A fool is a nastika. Therefore, in his reply, simply Yudhishthira said, Nastiko murkha uchyate. Within bracket, murkha api nastika uchyate. He integrated these two. So, here, who is a fool, who is an atheist? These two questions. So, what did he do? He integrated. A common answer given by is, an atheist is a fool and a fool is an atheist. Ko murkaha nastiko murkha uchyate. Ko murkha, ko nastikaha, murkaha nastika uchyate. Wonderful. Thus, according to Yashtarji, fool, murkha and nastika are synonymous. They are equal to him. Now why? Let us see now. This expression, nastika word, it has a special connotation in Sanskrit. Suffix is added, tadita pratyaya, suffix is added to tak, to the word nasti. So nasti means what? Does not exist. Na asti. Does not exist. What does not exist? The question led. Nasti means does not exist. Now the question is, what does not exist? What are you talking about? So the Siddhanta Kaumadi says, as per the Nastika word, does not exist. What is that does not exist? Paraloka. Paraloka or the world which is beyond our world, beyond the world which is not cognized or cognizable to our indriyas, is considered as paraloka. Iha and para. What is yahaloka? Indriya gocharam. That which is noticed or observed or experienced or through eyes, ears, nose, tongue, skin, seeing, smelling, tasting, touching and hearing. This is called yahaloka. That which cannot be smell, hear, touch, taste, touch, etc. See, it's called paraloka. So what is the nastika? That means what? A person, the pratyaya is added to denote a person's conviction, it is called. Suffix is added. It is denoting the person's conviction or opinion. Then who is astika then? A astika is one who believes in the world beyond. What is pramana? An astika, pramana is Veda. Atindriya vishayeshu Veda pramanam. Veda eva pramanam. So therefore, one who merely believes only, that is, in the material world, is an astika. Because he doesn't believe anything beyond. Meaning, what does he believe? He believes only in this world. When I say you don't believe or he doesn't believe that which is beyond, paraloka, ihaloka he believes? Yes. So he is a materialist. Who is a materialist? One who doesn't believe anything beyond. Then who is an astika? A materialist is an astika. We don't have to classify a special class of materialism other than nastika and astika that we do actually in the world. You are a nastika or astika? No, I am neither. I am a materialist. No, you can't answer like that. So that means the world is who doesn't believe the world beyond, majority of the population on the globe, they are nastikas then. They don't talk about it. The day I know that I am actually passing through a corridor called physical plane and I am actually being shunted from one room to other room and I am not allowed to take rest anywhere. From one loka to other loka I am shunted. Entry, exit, entry, exit, entry, exit. Like when you go to Akshardham, you go shunted from one room to other room. Those who have seen it. So one room is so very cool, quiet, very comfortable and you want to sit there. Now the moment the picture is over, that bit of 2 minutes or 3 minutes, they will shunt you. Go. First time when I went there, I thought I'll sit happily here for some time. 2 minutes ke baad jao bole. Kaha jana hai? Ona agle chamber. I am shunted. So we are also shunted from one plane to other plane. One loka to other loka. One existence to other existence. One experience to other experience. One state to other state. So, a materialistic can be called as a nastika. Okay. Now, who is a fool? A fool is one who does not know the fact or reality. Who is a fool? Murkha. Murkha means what? Who doesn't know the fact or reality. That's all, is it not? Who doesn't know the truth? Who doesn't know the fact? Who doesn't know the reality? He's a fool. Fool means he doesn't know. He doesn't know. Oh, don't ask him, he's a fool. In what? Maybe in cooking or playing or in one subject. He's a fool in mathematics, meaning he doesn't know anything about mathematics. He doesn't know the truth behind mathematics or reality behind mathematics. Who is a fool? Who doesn't know anything? Reality or the truth or a fact. Now, who is a nastika? Nastika who doesn't know the reality or a fact that which is beyond. So he is a fool or not? Okay, approved. So nastika is a murkha and a murkha is a nastika. That is all for 5 questions of Yaksha. Yudhishthira answered only 4. And he must have thanked in his mind. Thank you for intelligent question. I could integrate 2 questions in 1 answer. Mera samay bacha diya. Very wonderful. Therefore, a nastika is a fool and a fool is a nastika. What is nastika? Nastika means who doesn't believe in the existence of the world beyond. And who is a fool? Who doesn't know the reality or fact behind a particular thing? He is a fool. So nastika is a fool and fool is a nastika. Proved. So kappandita puman jneyaha nastika kasya uchyate ko murkaha dharmajna pandito jneyaha nastiko murkha uchyate within brackets murkaha nastika uchyate kasya kamaha. What is kama? Kama is what? Samsara hetuhu. Kamaha samsara hetu. What is that kama? Kama, bade bade kama, you know, you don't have to give a big definition. Samsara hetu, the cause of samsara. That's it. Cause of samsara is kama. Now what else I can tell now? You have read that Mahābhārata shlokam, no? Monkey Muni Charitra. Monkey. English monkey? Monkey, K-H-I. Oh. Aap apna monkey baat bataiye. I mean, if I tell the story, you know, oh, that Mahamuni, he sold everything, ultimately purchased 2 cows, and he was, or small bulls, you know, so taking them to agriculture field, one camel sitting on the road, these 2 are separated, tied with a big rope, and they are jumping on the road, and camel is facing that side. And this fellow, baby bull or whatever you call, on one side, other one is other side, and they could not move because the rope was obstructed by the neck of the camel, and they were pushing, and camel confused, suddenly got up, and they too committed suicide, suddenly hanging on either side of the camel's neck. And Monkey Munisa and Udgar, he came out, brought out his philosophy. That philosophy we saw. In that philosophy, he said, all this trouble is because of my desire. Kama janamite moolam sankalpat kila jayate. Oh Kama, therefore I will really uproot you along with the roots. I will not let you stay in my heart no more. And wonderful philosophy brought out. Monkey Muni, Udgar. We saw. Where? In Mahabharata. Wonderful. Udgar. So here, samsara hetuhu kamaha. Full stop. A modern definition, if you ask what is desire, that without which we cannot live. Modern answers would be like this only. Desire is that which fulfills our ambitions. Progress is impossible without the thrust called Trishna or desire. Very funny answers we give. Samsara hetuhu kamaha. Ko matsaraha. What is that matsaraha? He says, hruttapaha. Bah. Affliction in the heart is called as mattaha sarati iti matsaryam. Meaning he is overtaking me, going ahead of me. That's called envy. Ye mujhse aage ja rahe hain. It's called matsarya. So I have to catch him. I have to stop him, I have to catch him, or I should go first. I should overtake him. So this is called envy. So what is envy? Hruttapaha, I said. It's an affliction, a disease in the heart. Really speaking, when you are envious, literally speaking, physically also you would feel the heart burn here. Literally, there is no end for this. Suppose you are old and your daughter is not yet married, and some neighbor suddenly comes and then, "Hamari beti ki shadi tayi ho gayi." That's it. Hruttapaha. Oh, sweet good news you brought. Inside, burno burna. Think. कोई आगे कहता है कि मेरे बेटा का नौकरी लग गए, हृत्ताप. लिटरली यू कैन फील यहां पे सुख. एटलीस्ट एवरी ह्यूमन बीइंग वुड हैव एक्सपीरियंस्ड एटलीस्ट वंस, इवन इफ यू आर अ सेंट ऑफ ए साधक सेंट, नॉट ए हाई ऑर्डर सेंट or a Mahatma. Even on the path, somebody knows you, something more than you, hruttapa. Somebody sits for more time on meditation in a meditation group class, hruttapa. Now, there is a bed game. Chee, 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 chee. Komatsaraha hruttapaha. So in Bhagavatam, there is a wonderful sloka, it comes. Gunadhikat mudam mudam lipset anukrosham gunadhamat maitri samana samana danvichet natapaihi abhibhuyate. It says, seeing a person, gunadhikat mudam lipset. If you see somebody who has more qualities, good qualities than you, mudam lipset, you must experience joy. Gunadhikat mudam lipset anukrosham gunadhamat. If you see somebody who is inferior in the qualities compared to you, then what happened? Anukrosham, please be compassionate, show compassion. Then what? Maitri samada samanad anvichet. When you see another person equal in your qualities, same qualities as you are, he or she also has same, then feel friendship. One should cultivate friendship, not that you also got the same thing like me. Friendship. Yevam, I mean, natapaihi abhibhuyate. Such a quality if you maintain, then one will never be affected by tapa or affliction. Na tapaihi abhibhuyate. Bhagavad. So said by Naradji. Anyway, I was searching for this shloka, I could not get which exactly, but it is in Bhagavatam. The number I wanted, but there is no time. Chod gaya. Theek hai. So, gunadhikat mudam lipset anukrosham gunadhamat maitri samanadhan vichet natapaihi abhibhuyate. Then one is not afflicted by. So, tapa or hruttapa matsaraha is hruttapaha. This we have to conquer. Are we really serious about spiritual path? मैं बताता हूँ आपको जितना आप सुबह से शाम तक साधन किए होंगे फॉर एग्जाम्पल आप किसी व्यक्ति को देख के एक बार जल गया ना यू थिंक योर साधना इज बर्न्ड आप थोड़ा इकट्ठा किए होंगे ट्रेजर एक बार किसी को देख के जल गया क्या जल रहा है आपने आपका जो साधन की संपत्ति प्राप्त की आप उसी दिन सारे संपत्ति को एकदम जैसे कॉटन को जला देते हैं ना रुई एक बार फप भूम बस ये मन में रखना ये सच कह रहा हूं मैं हर विषय में हर चीज में वो उसका पेट में दो गुलाब जामुन ज्यादा खा रहा है तो उसका भी एनवी प्रताप इसका कोई सीमा नहीं है कोई सीमा नहीं है इसकी मत्सरा इज सच अ वंडरफुल एरिया इट्स लाइक ब्रह्मन इट इज ऑल पर्वेडिंग समबडी इज मोर ब्यूटिफुल इवन बाल्ड हेड मोर बाल्ड हेड लेस बाल्ड हेड दे ऑल्सो वृत्तापा अभी बाल बची है लक्की वृत्तापा और जो जिनका ज्यादा बाल्ड हेड हो गया वो खुश हो जाता है दूसरे दूसरे को देखिए तुम्हारे भी जा रहा है ना झर रहा है ना बाल अच्छा है बॉडी वेरी गुड खुश हॉरिबल इट इज सो व्हाट इज मत्सरह हृत्तापो मत्सरह उच्यते यक्षौवाच 99 हाउ मेनी श्लोकास हाउ मेनी थिंग्स वी हैव सीन सो फार 107 we saw. Out of 107, Yudhishthira answered only 106. Because he integrated Murkaha Nastika. Nastika Murkha. So remember, moreover, interesting example I told you, very factual example, Matsara. Even ek second hrut taap ka anubhav hua ho, यूं सोच लो समझ लो कि उस दिन की कम से कम साधना पूरा नष्ट हो गई एंड इफ यू मेंटेन कंसिस्टेंट हृत्ताप धीरे धीरे द वायरस एंटर इनटू द हार्ड डिस्क एंड मेमोरी बैंक एंड एवरीथिंग इज डिस्ट्रॉयड नॉट ओनली इट स्टॉप्स यू बट इट रियली डिस्ट्रॉयज अस heart bar. Once we conquer it, sarala bhav sir. And patient also, do patient ek hi din admit hua, aur kisi ko ek pehle din, do din pehle discharge hua, dusra fellow hurtap hota hai. Kya, you don't believe what I say? Hota hai. Ja rahe ho? Haan, discharge doctor ne kahi diya. कि आज तुम जा सकते हो अच्छा वृत्ताप दैट डे बेबी इज मोर शुगर इज मोर फिर डॉक्टर बोलते हैं बहुत बढ़ गया और चार दिन रोको नहीं पेशेंट पूछता है नहीं तो कितने दिन रखने वाले थे नहीं नहीं मैं सोचा था कल आपको डिस्चार्ज कर लूं मगर बहुत हालत खराब हो गई और चार दिन रहो ओके बस वृत्ताप तीन दिन बिल बढ़ गए हॉस्पिटल में और ज्यादा ताप इसके लिए भी बिल के लिए भी बिल ताप भी होता है नारायण सो नेक्स्ट श्लोक यक्ष उवाच कोहंकार इति प्रोक्तः कस्य दंभ प्रकीर्तितः किं तद्दैवं परम प्रोक्तं किं तत् पैशुन्यमुच्यते ಯಕ್ಷೌವಾಚ ಕೋಹಂಕಾರ ಇತಿ ಪ್ರೋಕ್ತಃ. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಹಂಕಾರ ಆರ್ ಈಗೋ? ಕಶ್ಯ ದಂಭ ಪ್ರಕೀರ್ತಿತಃ. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಂಭ? ದಂಭ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಹಿಪೋಕ್ರಸಿ, ಕನ್ಸೀಟ್. ಕಿಂ ತತ್ ದೈವಂ ಪರಂ ಪ್ರೋಕ್ತಂ. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೆಟ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಪರಂ ಪ್ರೋಕ್ತ ದೈವಂ ಪರಂ ಪರಂ ದೈವಂ ಪ್ರೋಕ್ತಂ. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೆಟ್ ಟು ಬಿ ದ ಸುಪ್ರೀಂ ಡಿವೈನ್ ನೇಚರ್, ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಸುಪ್ರೀಂ ಡಿವೈನ್ ಡಿವಿನಿಟಿ. ಅಚ್ಛಾ, ಕಿಂ ತತ್ ಪೈಶೂನ್ಯ ಮುಚ್ಚತೆ. ಪೈಶೂನ್ಯ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಬೈಟಿಂಗ್, ಸ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಡರಿಂಗ್, ಮಡ್ ಸ್ಲಿಂಗಿಂಗ್. ಓಕೆ, ಫೋರ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ಸ್. ಕೋಹಂಕಾರ ಇತಿ, ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಹಂಕಾರಂ? ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಂಭ? ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪರಂ ದೈವಂ? ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪೈಶೂನ್ಯಂ? ಯುಧಿಷ್ಠಿರ ಉವಾಚ, ಮಹಾಜ್ಞಾನಮಹಂಕಾರ ದಂಭೋ ಧರ್ಮೋ ಧ್ವಜೋತ್ರಯ ದೈವಂ ದಾನಫಲಂ ಪ್ರೋಕ್ತಂ ಪೈಶೂನ್ಯಂ ಪರದೂಷಣಂ. ಯುಧಿಷ್ಠಿರ ಸೇ, ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್, ಕೋ ಅಹಂಕಾರ ಇತಿ ಪ್ರೋಕ್ತಃ? ಮಹಾ ಅಜ್ಞಾನಂ ಅಹಂಕಾರ. ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಹಂಕಾರ? ಮಹಾ ಅಜ್ಞಾನಂ ಇಸ್ ಅಹಂಕಾರ. ಅಬ್ ದೇಖಿಯೆ, ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಲಿಸನ್, ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಹಂಕಾರ? ದ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಟಿ, ದ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್, ಐ ಆಮ್. ದ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಎ ಬಹುತ್ ವೆರಿ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ಐ. ಅಚ್ಛಾ, ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗರ್ ದ ಐ, ಗ್ರೇಟರ್ ದಿ ಇಗ್ನೋರೆನ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಅಹಂಕಾರ ಈಸ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನಲ್ ಟು ದಿ ಡೆನ್ಸಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಇಗ್ನೋರೆನ್ಸ್. ಹೌ ಥಿಕ್ ಇಸ್ ಡಾರ್ಕ್ನೆಸ್? ಗಾಢಾಂಧಕ. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಈ ಸೇಸ್, ನೌ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಹಂಕಾರ? ಸಿಂಪಲ್, ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಸೀ, ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಹಂಕಾರ? ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಗೋ? ದಟ್ ವಿಚ್ ಸೆಪರೇಟ್ಸ್ ಅಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಟೋಟಾಲಿಟಿ. ಅನದರ್ ಡೆಫಿನಿಷನ್, ಐ ಐ ಐ ಐ ಐ ಜಾದಾ ಜಬ್ ಬೋಲ್ನೆ ಲಗ್ ಜಾತೆ ಹೇ ಹಮ್, ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ವಿ ಟ್ರೈಂಗ್ ಟು ಡೂ? ವಿ ಆರ್ ಎಲಿನೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಅವರ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್, ವಿ ಆರ್ ಸೀಕಿಂಗ್ ಎ ಸ್ಪೆಷಲ್ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಟಿ. ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಕಟಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಟಿ ಆರ್ ಟೋಟಾಲಿಟಿ, ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ನಾಟ್? ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಯಲೈಸೇಷನ್? Losing that individual identity and becoming one with the totality. Full stop. So in Ahankara, that which separates us from others is Ahankara. Okay. Now, what is ignorance of one's own nature? Is non-apprehension of the truth. So one's own truth, nature, if I don't apprehend, non-apprehension of truth is called Swabhavika Ajnanam, ignorance of one's own nature. Okay. So, that means what? Non-apprehension of truth itself creates ego. Got the point now? So non-apprehension of the truth creating ego in us, a separate identity. When I know the truth as one, then the identity is no more there. So what is mean one means what? What is ego actually doing? Ego is creating walls. Ego, what is it? What does ego do? It creates thick walls. And there are, you can see strong ego. Strong ego, you know, though, even though you tickle them, they don't smile, they don't laugh. I mean, very funny, I can't explain it. They're such a egoistic, not only the beating their own, no, they think that they are unique creatures and they don't want to be identified as something low, and they cannot tolerate what do you call, any insult, even the prachaksha or a paroksha insult also they cannot tolerate. Suppose a man who is absolute, very simple man, chalta chalta gir gaya ho, in some public mein, he doesn't feel so bad about it. He gets up, oh, gir gaya main, very good. आज राम गड्ढा में गिर गए, किसने बताया? राम तीर्थ चल रहे थे गड्ढा में गिर गए, हाय आज राम तो गड्ढे में गिर गए, उठ गए फिर चल गए। लोग देख रहे थे हाय क्या सिंपल है। एंड स्पेशली व्हेन द ग्रुप व्हेन यू फॉल डाउन वेरी पिक्यूलर ईगो हॉन्ट्स अस, हाय राम सबके सामने गिर गई। अच्छा हुआ ना कम से कम लोग है मदद करने के, अकेले गिर अकेले गिर गई हो पहाड़ों में या तो जंगल में, कोई जानवर आके देखता है कि मदद करूं। अच्छा है ना सबके सामने गिर गए तो कोई कोई ना कोई मदद देते हैं। पागल है रियली, दैट इज कॉल्ड ईगो। वेरी 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 टफ, वेरी आई मीन वेरी टफ, आई मीन मीन्स वेरी टफ, आई कांट से एनीथिंग वेरी। So ego is that creating walls. Therefore, and what is the cause of ego? Ignorance of divine nature. What is cause of ego? Ignorance of our own swarupa. Therefore, Yudhishthira says, Maha Ajnanam is Ahankara. What is Ahankara? Maha, the greater the ignorance, greater the ego. Greater the ego, greater is our special identity we seek in society. And very interesting, when we are alone, all alone, there is no expression of ego. In the sense what? In public, in terms of recognition or name and fame and social conscience, the conscious of the society around, public awareness, listen, people are watching me, all those things. The moment I come out, my actions change, my dress, bar, sajana. Very funny nature comes out. Actually, maja aata hai dekhne mein. The free cartoon show. Anyway, so if ignorance is said to be the cause, that is ahankara or the sense of strong identity is separating us from the totality, that is called ego. So ego creates walls and directly proportional to ignorance. The sense of identity which is there, a special identity what we see, something very unique in the universe, that is Maha Ajnanam. So that means stronger the ego, greater is the ignorance. So what is the cause of ego? Ajnanam, Swarupa Ajnanam. Therefore, ego is what? Ajnanam. Maha Ajnanam is Ahankaram. Wonderful. Now, Kohankara iti proktaha महाअज्ञानमहंकारः कश्च दम्भप्रकीर्तितः सेज दम्भो धर्मध्वज उच्छ्रयः। नाउ दम्भ इज स्पीक धर्मध्वज, वॉट एवर यू आर धार्मिक बट यू आर होल्डिंग युअर ओन जेंडा ऑफ युअर धर्म सो हाई, यू आर स्पीकिंग अबाउट युअर सेल्फ वेरी हाई ऑलवेज। You hold your, whatever dharmic deed you did, whatever you did, you hold that dhvaja very high in your own hand and want people to recognize you. As Guruji beautifully says, the Vartaja manager, you know, even though you are out of power as a minister or a prime minister, but the card is always ex-minister, he has to carry that. The ghost follows. So, dambha, what is dambha? Speaking always high about oneself, boosting one's own observance of dharma in the world. You keep on boosting. Maine aisa kiya, maine aisa kiya, daan diya, maine aisa kiya, main to aise karta hu. मेरे घर में तो हमेशा खाना रहती है, दोनों को दो लोगों के लिए खाना ज़्यादा रहती है, एक कम से कम एक तो हमेशा कभी भी आ सकते हैं हमारे घर में, हमारे खानदान में ये नियम है। And the flood is coming and I can't resist it. हम तो बहुत साधु लोग को बहुत खिलाया करते थे या कर रहे हैं, अभी भी करते हैं। हमारे परिवार में ऐसा होते थे, अब मैं ऐसे ही करती हूँ, सुबह मैं जागती हूँ 4 बजे, सबको डिस्टर्ब करती हूँ। वॉट एवर यू, वेरी वेरी फनी, this is comes out actually. So boasting of one's own observance of dharma in the world is what constitutes dambha, pride, I mean hypocrisy. So speaking or blowing our own trumpets as well as boasting oneself with such qualities is two things, huh? One is what you have, you speak about very high about yourself, glorifying your qualities again and again is one type, and other is speaking those qualities which you don't have, also a type of horrible dambha, boosting something. Both are dangerous. So Bhagavan Krishna says, no, amanitvam, in 13th chapter it starts with amanitvam, adambitvam, ahimsa kshantirarjavam acharyopasanam shaucham sthairyam आत्मविनिग्रह, वेरी वंडरफुल. सो कस्य दम्भ प्रकृतितः धर्म दम्भः धर्मध्वजः उच्छ्रयः. नौ किं तद्दैवं परं प्रोक्तं दैवं दानफलं प्रोक्तं. द रिजल्ट ऑफ दानम आर चैरिटी इज कॉल्ड दैवं, दानफलं दैवं प्रोक्तं, दानफलं इज दैवं प्रोक्तं. व्हाई? The Lord is one. Who is the Lord? He is available to us all the time. Number one. Of course, provided we invoke Him, He is available. So, now, He is always available. And who is the giver in the universe? The Lord alone is the giver. Rest all of us are receivers only. Okay. If a person lives only for, but for, you know, lives not for oneself, but for totality, I live for totality, not for myself, giving to the world around whatever he has in possession, in his possession, giving them to the world around, then what becomes? He becomes a mini god among human beings. Think. Bolte ki nahi to Bhagwan hi hai. सब कुछ सबको देते रहते हैं, अपने लिए कुछ रखते नहीं. इज अ ग्रेट त्यागी, ही गिव्स एवरीथिंग टू एवरीवन, शेयर्स, चैरिटी ही गिव्स, ही बिकम्स अ गॉड इन द फैमिली, इज इट नॉट? है कि नहीं? गॉड्स इन द फैमिली, देयर मेनी गॉड्स इन द फैमिलीज, मेनी फैमिलीज. एक व्यक्ति ऐसा होता है एक्चुअली घरों में, ये सारे परिवार लोगों का बड़ा सपोर्ट बन के रहता है वो अपने जीवन में, सब लोग झुक झुक के रहता है, निष्कलमश, निष्कपट, ही इज अ गॉड. हमारे कुल का ये भगवान है, मैं परिवार में भगवान ही मानते हैं उनको. सुना नहीं क्या आप ऐसा? So a god in the family, a god in society, a god in the country. So a person becomes great, he becomes more and more greater and greater, the more he lives for samishti, understand, the more he is living for totality, more he becomes greater and greater in his own inner expansion, dimension of, and not vesti, he is not interested in vesti, more and more expanding. Such a person is called a moving god on earth. Therefore, Yudhishthira says, giving is the nature of God, since giving is the nature of the God. And one who cultivates that giving as a second nature of him, or a Svabhava ultimately become first nature, he himself is God. Giving what? Whatever you have. So, giving is the nature of God, and dana phalam daivam, he said. And what is the dana phalam? Giving, sharing everything, you become that only. What is that you become? That quality is nothing but divine quality, and you become divine. You live for everybody. Love. Love is substratum. Love is the basis of operation. Slap, anger, they are all expressions of love only. No hatred in the heart. So, and by giving, one becomes God. Therefore, what did he say? Daivam, what do you call it? Daivam dhanapalam proktam. Dhanapalam is called daivam. It is said, proktam, it is said that the result, the phala of charity is daivam. You start thinking, how come dana phalam is daivam? Ultimately the phalam is this only. Ultimately dana phalam, you keep on giving, what is the phalam you get now? Chota mota phal to mil jata hai pehle. But then you are giving, more and more you are giving. You become divine in your nature. Beautiful. Then what is that? Kim tat paishunya mucchate. Paishunya means, I said, backbiting. Paishunyam. And he says, paishunyam paradushanam. Paradushanam, criticizing others, talking very evil of others, others bad, is called paishunyam, slandering. It's called slandering. That is called paradushanam, is paishunyam. Achcha, now let us see. What do you mean, paishunyam? Meaning talking ill of others in their absence. Step by step, let us go. In their absence, when we talk, this becomes paishunyam, talking ill of others. It's called backbiting. Okay, now, greatest harm that we can bring to any person is through backbiting. It's called character assassination. It's very easy to assassinate somebody's character. Very easy. In a flash, you can kill somebody's character and kill him also. Nowadays, technology is more. One SMS, one email. It just spreads virus all over the world. In olden days, you know, at least character, at least जो नारी लोग जाते हैं पानी लाने के लिए वहां पे कुछ होता है ना, तो men sit in veranda, जो पत्ते खेलते रहे वहां पे कुछ हो सकता है, backbiting. But आजकल SMS is enough, email is enough. कोई मीडिया वालों को बुला लो, हो गया काम, सारे दुनिया फैल जाती है. Not only when Noida is always comes in that channel, you know, every now and then, something or other. And people ask me, aap kahan se? Noida. Oh, bolte pehle. Abhi bhi bolte, aap kahan se? Noida. Noida, acha, oh. Acha, oh. First of all, first time I thought that they are praising me. Then I realized. Then the people started asking me, आपका आश्रम कहाँ है? तो nearest to 33 sector. अच्छा, वहीं रहते आप? पास में ही. कितना दूर है? Less than kilometer. हाँ. अच्छा, आकर में आप कभी आइए आश्रम? नहीं स्वामी जी, बहुत busy है. It's spread like anything. देखा, शहर का बदनाम, जगह का बदनाम, व्यक्ति का बदनाम, देश का बदनाम, In their absence particularly, suppose you talk, horrible it is. That's why Mahatmas, when yogis, you know, you can't wag their tails in front of them. But they know what you spoke outside and before coming into the ashram. मुंह में बोल देते हैं अच्छा अच्छा बात में बाहर क्या कह रहे थे तुम उनसे मैं क्या कहा स्वामी जी नहीं नहीं मैं बताऊं हाँ बता दो पूरा बता देता डायलॉग के बाद डायलॉग चुपचाप तब महात्मा सर दे दैट्स व्हाई यू नो टू लिव इन द वर्ल्ड आल्सो वी नीड दैट दैट आध्यात्मिक शक्ति पैशून्यम नाउ लेट अस सी So, a Mahatma said, you know, if anyone comes to you to talk something, immediately ask the person, are you talking good or bad? First question. Number two, is it a heard message or did you see it for yourself personally? Number three, it is a bad, if it is bad and not directly useful to me, then don't tell me. It's wonderful. Third, Fourth, if it is bad and related to me and it is necessary for me to know, then tell without holding hatred in your heart. Tell me in such a way that it should not agitate my mind and also offer me a solution. You type these 4-5 points and lagate rehna, jeb mein, 1 minute. Maine suna, wo suno, haji, aapne suna, ya, suru. Bhartruhari says about backbiting in one of his shlokas, so wonderful it is, about slandering. Aho kalabhaja kala aho kalabhujangasya vichitroyam vadhakramaha anyasya dashate srotram anyapranair vayujyate. Beautiful it is. Aho, he says, Bhartruhari says, slandering person, what does he do? He bites the ear of a person. One person. And it affects whom? The third person. A eats the ear of B. Mane kaan mein kuch kaan kaata. Literal translation. Kaan kaatne ke baad, that B, what did I tell B? About C. And B will tell to D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z. Taali bajao because I know all alphabets now. That means, Aho, Kalabhujangasya, Vichitraya, Vadhakrama. This krama of the method of killing somebody is very strange. Anyasya dashati stotram, srotram. When one somebody bites the ear of some person, A bites B. That's it. Anya prana irvyujjate. Who ultimately loses the life? C. And C would never know who started it. Think. Ubhishara, you know, almost is living but dead only. Impossible for C to know where it started. Who started it? Vadhakramaha vichitraha. Ayam vadhakrama. Vadha means killing. Krama means order. We're systematical. I eat somebody, that's enough. About third person. So, and it's just like a snake, kala bhujangasya. Why? Because a snake always attacks without your knowledge. Snake will not come in front and say, shall I bite you? When you are unaware, snake bites. When you are living life with your own principles, you are very good, honest, somebody is very jealous of your name and fame, your progress. He starts. How? Not directly. If somebody tells him, Suna, maine suna iske bare, maine dekha, bas. It just goes off. And this man would not be able to live further. With insult, with degradation, with the very bad feeling, and then he just, how many, even to such great Mahatmas, they could not escape this slandering. Bhagavan Krishna also got the ninda. You know that? Samantakamani. And he had to struggle hard to prove that he is innocent. So, Paishunyam is backbiting, Paradushanam. So, very horrible this is. Chalo, next shloka. Yakshauvacha dharmascharyascha kamascha paraspara virodhinah yesham nitya viruddhanam khatamekatra sangamah. One question only. Not four, only one. So far we have seen 111. This is 112th one. He says, dharmascha, arthascha, kamascha, paraspara virodhinaha. Dharma, artha and kama are mutually contradicting and mutual enemies actually. Means they cannot be brought together. And with little, somehow, you know, but though we say, artha, wealth is to be generated through righteous means, in wealth, in procuring wealth, absolute 100% dharma is not possible. And kama, fulfilling desires, only through dharma, not possible. Kama, one or two, three, four times, five, many times it crosses the limits of dharma. So paraspara virodhinaha. They are virodhis. Dharma and artha and kama are virodhis. Are opposite to one another. Ah, bol dena lo. Paisa kamana ho to dharma ko chodna hai. And to fulfill, if you want real, apne desires fulfill karna ho, तो अर्थ की चाहिए तो अर्थ बिना विद धर्म यू कांट बिकॉज माय डिजायर्स आर सो मेनी दैट आई कांट फुलफिल विद माय सैलरी सो आई हैव टू बिकम करप्ट लाइक आर थ्रू अनराइचुअस मींस समहाउ आई मस्ट अर्न वेल्थ झूठ बोलो कुछ भी करो So these three are, if you 100% dharma, you want dharma, dharma, dharma. Even if you are a businessman, then profit is unavoidable. Jhooth to bolna padta. Suppose you ask a businessman, what is the actual cost? Actual cost is MRP. Jhooth to bolta hai. The way we earn money, whatever job we are doing, some element of dishonesty, either you or department or the industry. Koi na koi aur kisi ko dhoka ke bina hai na paisa nahi kama raha koi company. Or even though you are dharmic, the people who pay money to you must have been earned by foul means. Sun liya apne? Even those who donate money, charity, in what you, in Balaji is getting honest money, Tirupati Balaji. He is also shareholder of a black market. Of black market. So these three are paraspar virodhis. Yesham Nitya Viruddhanam. This constant among these three Nitya Viruddhanam, among these three we who are opposed to each other Nitya constantly always, Katam Ekatra Sangamaha, how to bring these three together? For which Yudhishthira answers. Wonderful. Do you understand the question or not? Unique question, huh? Yudhishthira uvacha. Now you see, on this we can talk minimum, at least to make ourselves understand, not less than 1 hour. But utna time to nahi hota hai hamare paas. Let us see. Yada Yudhishthira uvacha, yada dharmascha bharyacha paraspara paraspara vashanugau tada dharmartha kamanam trayanam apisangamah. Now he says, yada, when dharmascha bharyacha paraspara vashanugau, when a wife, bharya, plus virtue, dharma, when they agree with each other, bharya, the wife, and dharma agree to each other, then tada dharma artha kamanam trayanam api sangamaha, then the dharma artha kama sangama can take place. What simple answer he gave? Bharya and dharma should be together. That's what he answered. So one question he asked here. Let us see now. If a wife heartily means happily, cheerfully, assists. Now one thing, later on we'll see the complications. Assists the husband. Bharya is called Saha Dharma Charini. See the other name. Who is Bharya? Sahadharma Charini. Meaning she is supposed to assist her husband in his dharma karyas. That is the duty of Bharya. When we say life partner, life partner for what? For fulfilling basic urges? Life partner. What is life? Then your life partner karke, misunderstanding, and then what you call life partner, and what is that? That means what? Life is understood, misunderstood there. That means life is only for that? That is what is understanding. What is life partner? Then one has to help me in the principles of my life, whatever I am living. If a wife is assisting her husband, who is a dharma? You should be dharma. Now, later on, other part we will see now. Both the sides are corrupted now. But somewhere we have to start, na? Now you say, for example, our vicious cycle of our society. Poverty to be eradicated. Yes. Kya karna chahiye? Now if you start poverty, or you, for example, the vicious cycle, anywhere you can start. Poverty, how education required. If you educate, poverty can be removed. So that skill, technical skill, whatever it is. Okay. So start educating. No, for education, food is to be supplied because they are unhealthy, hungry. So first solve the hunger problem. Poverty linked to education, education is linked to hunger. Hunger is linked to what? We have to solve hunger problem. Okay, we'll solve. But then who should solve it? Others should help. Mutual society should help. Government should help. Society should help. But the corruption. So in order to see that everybody is satiated without any hunger in country, corruption has to be controlled. Achcha. Now what to do with to control corruption? People to be educated. Wah. sensitize them, evoke in them empathy and sympathy. Now the vicious cycle. Somebody, child labor to be removed, very good. Now why children are sent for labor? Parents earning, they are not getting any money. 10 rupees, 2 rupees, 3 rupees per day. Or 12 rupees, 15 rupees. Exploitation is there. If there is no exploitation, children, every child can go to school. Our country is not poor. Huh? Black money is too much. And also Swiss bank is heavy money is there. But dil nahi hai na, logon mein. We are waiting, you do first, you do first. It's a vicious cycle. Or somewhere health comes into picture. Kaam sikhao. Kaam sikhane ke liye kisi mein taakat nahi hai. Majboor banao, pehle khana khilao. Vicious cycle. So I am not entering into vicious cycle now. Who is to be the knight? But somewhere we have to start now. Start somewhere, some program. Don't wait. When is that vicious cycle would break? Then only I will be able to serve society. It will not break so easily. Not in near future at least. So here, who is the wife? Wife is the one who should heartily, happily assist her husband in the pursuit of three objectives of life: dharma, artha and kama. So when a wife assists, then what happens? Then these three contradictions may coexist. Where these three contradictions are coexisting, this among the contradictions, these three apparent contradictions would coexist. They become one. Sangama takes place. Dharma, artha and kama. When bharya is dharmavati. Full stop. Now, how, what is the role of bharya, what is dharma, how she brings in that family harmony. It's very good. In Valmiki Ramayana, Rama says, dharma artha kama kilata taloke samikshita dharma phaladayeshu etatra sarve surasamshayam me Bharyaiva vashya abhimata suputra. Bhagavan Ramji says, for the dharma artha kamaha, for the attainment of the fruits of dharma, artha and kama, these three ke liye, undoubtedly, all the three, loke samikshata dharma palada yeshu yetatra sarve, syu asamshayam me bharya eva. All these three, Rama Bhagavan says, coexist. In his opinion, Bhagavan Ram, it's my opinion. Where does they exist? In wife, who is obedient. An obedient wife is there, obedient to dharma. In that wife, all the three would coexist, Ramayana, Valmiki Ramayana says. One whose wife is obedient, acceptable, and also abhimatasu putra, and also endowed with a good son. A son who is supporting father in his dharma karyas. So bharya, because son also is trained by mother only. So bharya is the answer. So when bharya is dharmavati, Yudhishthira says, all these three, though they are contradicting, opposed to each other, would coexist. When, as per our culture I am talking, Indian culture. So in Bhagavan, I mean Mahabharata also we saw, you know, and this sloka will come again in coming parvas also. The thought, that not that according to Varsha, woman is not, woman is, people curb her independence, that is not independence. It is actually dependence. The whole country, the culture, the future of the country, all depending on mother. family system, unit, dharma, everything depending on that. A heavy responsibility, loaded with responsibilities. Once she comes out, vengeance, hatred, comparison, when she steps out of dharma, the family system collapses like a placards, that the building made up of playing cards, placards, they collapse. Family unit, the unit breaks, building breaks. Each brick in the building becomes loose, that's it. And in country will become stronger as long as there are family values, family traditions, respect. That hold. Who should hold all of them together? Mother of the family, full stop. Otherwise, there is no chance. If not today, even after 1,000 years, if you want to revive our culture, it has to come again the same basic tenets of our culture, that wife is the first source. Therefore, Matru Devo Bhava, first one. That's it. It has to come back again. If we don't realize today, nature would force us to realize this truth down the line. Down the line. If not today, humanity doesn't learn lesson. और आगे और बिगड़ने के बाद मजबूरी से सीखना पड़ता है और कोई रास्ता नहीं दिखाई देता. यक्ष उवाच अक्षयो नरकः केन प्राप्यते भरतर्षभ एतन्मे पृच्छत प्रश्नम् तत्श्रीघ्रं वक्तुमर्हसि. Yaksha said again, now anyway that's enough now, that also we know that there is always behind every successful man, there is an intelligent, there is a wife. Wife means a woman. Woman means mother, could be sister, somebody. Okay. Now, he says in 103rd shloka, Akshayo narakah kena praptite bharatarshabha. Okay. Kena prapyate, by whom this akshaya naraka, everlasting hell, is attained? Or who would go to, what person would go to everlasting hell? Akshaya naraka. Everlasting means long, long time, at least as long as our Yama is there. Long, as at least one kalpa, maybe. Everlasting suffering. Hell means suffering. Who would attain that? A Bharatas Bharatarshabha. Yetanme Purchata Prashnam. Now that question which I asked now, you, Shigram Vaktumarhasi, please tell me fast. Why? Great commentators have commented here that maybe Yaksha is asking Yudhishthira quickly. He doesn't want to disturb the evening sandhya of Yudhishthira. That's a great Mahatma's commented at Sanjha Samaya. Now I want also go. I also other work is there. I'm dharma speaking in the form of yaksha. Now I can't hold you. You are answering so wonderfully. Now padabat bol do, then aapko chod dunga. Hardly over 8 or 10 questions are left. I will answer, I mean ask them, you will answer me, and so that immediately you can be relieved. Padabat bol do. This question which I am asking now, please answer me quickly. Okay. Now, he gives answers in 104, 105, 106. In 3 shlokas he gives Yudhishthira for this answer. Who, by whom, or which person does attain Akshaya Naraka, everlasting hell? By whom it is attained? Akshayo, that's one. Yudhishthira uvacha, brahmanam swayam ahuya, yachamanam akinchinam, paschan nastiti yo bruyat, so akshayam narakam rajet, vedeshu dharma shastreshu, mithyayo vaitvijatishu, ದೇವೇಶು ಪಿತೃಧರ್ಮೇಶು ಸೋ ಅಕ್ಷಯಂ ನರಕಂ ವ್ರಜೇತ್ ವಿದ್ಯಮಾನೇ ಧನೇ ಲೋಭಾತ್ ಧಾನಭೋಗ ವಿವರ್ಜಿತಃ ಪಶ್ಚಾನ್ನಾಸ್ತೀತಿ ಯೋ ಬ್ರೂಯಾತ್ ಸೋ ಅಕ್ಷಯಂ ನರಕ ನರಕಂ ವ್ರಜೇತ್ ಹಿ ಅಟೈನ್ಸ್ ಎವರ್ ಲಾಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಹೆಲ್ತ್ ತ್ರೀ ಆನ್ಸರ್ಸ್ ಈ ಗಿವ್ ತ್ರೀ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟರ್ಸ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಬ್ರಾಹ್ಮಣಂ ಸ್ವಯಂ ಆಹೂಯ ಯಾಚಮಾನಂ ಬ್ರಾಹ್ಮಣಂ ಸ್ವಯಂ ಆಹೂಯ ಅಕಿಂಚನಂ ಪಶ್ಚಾ ನಾಸ್ತಿ ಯೋ ಬ್ರೂಯಾತ್ ಯು ಇನ್ವೈಟೆಡ್ ಬ್ರಾಹ್ಮಣ ಬ್ರಾಹ್ಮಣ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಎ ಸಾಧಕ ಎ ಸ್ಪೀಕರ್ ಎ ಜೆಂಟಲ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಎ ನೈಸ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಇಂಟೆಲಿಜೆಂಟ್ ಕರೇಜಿಯಸ್ ಸ್ಪಿರಿಚುವಲ್ ಬೆಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ ನೈಸ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಎ ಬ್ರಾಹ್ಮಣ ಗುಡ್ ಕ್ವಾಲಿಟೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಎ ಋಷಿ ಎ ಸೇಜ್ ಆರ್ ಎ ಸಾಧು ಎ ಸಾಧಕ ಎ ಸೀಕರ್ ಆಫ್ ಟ್ರೂತ್ ಯು ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಅಚ್ಛಾ ವಾಲಂಟರಿಲಿ ಯು ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಸ್ವಯಂ ಆಹೂಯ ನಾಟ್ ಅಟ್ ಹೀ ಬ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಡ್ ಯುವರ್ ಡೋರ್ ಯು ಓನ್ಲಿ ಗೋ ಇನ್ವೈಟ್ ಹಿಮ್ ಫಾರ್ ಭಿಕ್ಷಾ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ ಹಿಮ್ ಟು ಯುವರ್ ಹೌಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಕಾಲಿಂಗ್ ಹಿಮ್ ಪಶ್ಚಾತ್ ನಾಸ್ತಿ ಇದು ಯೋ ಬ್ರೂಯಾತ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಮ್ಯಾನ್ ಕೇಮ್ ಟು ಟೇಕ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಯು ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಸೊ ಹೀ ಕೇಮ್ ಟು ಯುವರ್ ಹೌಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಕಮ್ ಟು ಯುವರ್ ಹೌಸ್ ಯು ವುಡ್ ಟೆಲ್ ಹಿಮ್ ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ನೋ ನೋ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್ ನೌ ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಗೋ ಅವೇ ಹೀ ಗೋಸ್ ಟು ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಶಾಲ್ ಐ ಗಿವ್ ಯು ಮಾಡರ್ನ್ ಪಾರ್ಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಅವರ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಹೌ ವರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ಸಪೋಸ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಟೆಲಿಂಗ್ ಯು ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಕಮಿಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ವೆನ್ ನಾಟ್ ಹಾನರ್ಡ್ ಯು ಗೋ ಟು ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ಯು ಗೋ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ ಸೋ ಮೆನಿ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಇನ್ ಹಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ವಿ ಸಾ ಯು ಆರ್ ಸಡನ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ಸ್ಪೈರ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಸೀಯಿಂಗ್ ಎ ಪ್ರಾಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ಎನ್ ಆಶ್ರಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯು ಕಾಂಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ದ ಲೋಕಲ್ ಮಹಂತ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಪೀಠಾಧಿಪತಿ ಆರ್ ದ ಸ್ವಾಮಿ ದೇರ್ ಗೋ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಟಾಕ್ ಟು ದೆಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆರ್ ಮ್ಯಾನೇಜರ್ ಸಂಬಡಿ ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಹೆಡ್ ಸಂಬಡಿ ಮೀಟ್ ಅಲ್ಟಿಮೇಟ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ರೈಟ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಸೊ ಐಮ್ ಸೋ ಹ್ಯಾಪಿ ಐ ಆಮ್ ರಿಯಲಿ ಮೂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಬ್ರಿಂಗ್ ಮೈ ಚೆಕ್ ಬುಕ್ ಟುಡೇ ನಾರ್ ಐ ಬ್ರಾಟ್ ಮೈ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಬಟ್ ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಕಮ್ ಟು ಮೈ ಹೌಸ್ ಐ ವಾಂಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಡೊನೇಟ್ ನೌ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಅನೌನ್ಸಿಂಗ್ 5 lakhs ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಕಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಯು ಗಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಈ ಗೋಸ್ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಶ್ರಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಸೇಸ್ ಬುದ್ಧು ವೈ ಡಿಡ್ ಯು ಕಮಿಟ್ 5 lakhs ಯು ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಇನ್ ಸೆನ್ಸಸ್ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಕಮಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಅಪನೆ ಆಪ್ಕೋ ಭೂಲ್ ಗೇ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಯುವರ್ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸೈಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಕಮಿಟೆಡ್ 5 lakhs ದಿಸ್ ಹಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ಡೋಂಟ್ ನೋ ಅದರ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ದೇ ವೆರಿ ಹ್ಯಾಪಿ ಸೊ ದೇ ಗೋ ಟು ದಿಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಹೌಸ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಸಂಡೇ ವೆನ್ ಎವರ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ Meanwhile, he had decided to tell lies. But exactly the next day only share market fell. I lost 25 lakhs. Otherwise, I would have given 10 lakhs to you. But though I committed 5 lakhs, my khandan is very committed people. Definitely, I would give. I discussed this with my wife also. And we settled for 21,000. You must appreciate, sir, in spite of these hard times, in difficulties, during these hard times also, we are honoring our commitment of donating something from our pocket to your prestigious organization for your most noble and valued society to service to society. Actually, hua kya? Kuch nahi hua. His miser bhava came out. His own swabhava, you reduce it, you know, made him speak like this, kanjusi. Nasti iti yo vadati. Still other, sir, aapne hame bulaya, kab? नहीं उस दिन हमसे मिला कहाँ? आप तो आए थे मंदिर में, कौन? मेरा भाई आया होगा, वो भी बिल्कुल मेरे जैसे दिखता है। अच्छा हाँ, ट्विंस फॉर एवर, ओ हो, इंक्लूडिंग बाल, यस यस, वॉइस, थ्रोट, एवरीथिंग, यस। अभी हमें क्या करना है पता नहीं, भाई आने के बाद पूछ लीजिए। दिस इज हाउ द वर्ल्ड गोज ऑन। इफ यू डोंट हॉनर ए कमिटमेंट टू ए महात्मा, टू ए गुरु, टू ए ब्राह्मण, दे डोंट डू एनीथिंग, दैट्स अ टेरेबल सिन। सच ए पर्सन वुड गो टू हेल। इन द सेंस व्हाट? हेल इज नॉट अ रीजन अगेन, दे आर कलेक्टेड अ डिफरेंट इश्यू अगेन, बट एन कॉन्स्टेंट सफरिंग वुड बी फेल्ट एज ए ग्रेट ब्लंडर वॉज कमिटेड बाई दिस फेलो। अक्षयम नरकम प्रजेत, ही गोज टू अक्षय। नाउ वन मोर आंसर, टू मोर क्वेश्चन, श्लोकास आर देयर दैट वी विल सी टुमारो। सो फार वी हैव सीन 113, नॉट सीन, 113th आंसर इज गोइंग ऑन क्वेश्चन, 113th क्वेश्चन। ओम पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। ओम शांति शांति शांति। हरि ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। हरि ओम सद्गुरुनाथ महाराज की।